Alright, so this is a demonstration video how to assemble the junction for the braiding machine. This module has a servo on the bottom that actuates the top tooth to turn and guide the carriers moving past it. This tooth is set up so that it doesn't have a central axis of rotation, but it rotates about these two M3 screws, which has spacers to place it. And it's actuated by the shaft that goes through down to the servo, and there's this servo holder that is, we have two different designs, so this is the new design, more sort of cylindrical and simpler than the old design. And seen from the top to the bottom, we have two M3 nuts that hold on to this little thing that translates, and also this is the weakest point, so your servo won't break, but this part will break before the servo. If you do something wrong, and this is actuating the tooth that I'm holding here, that sits held down by these M3s with washers, two spacers, and then we have the sort of inserted or the inserts that hold the thread that the nuts, that the screws from the top are holding onto this, and the screws from the bottom are so they are sharing like half of the thread each. Then we have the base plate, the square plate, and then this is the difference. This one can host four modules, whereas this one can just sit on the edge and hold two modules. Then we have two M3 screws of different lengths in the bottom, one with a washer. And the shaft comes from the servo, and the servo is held by this the servo bracket. So I'll just start assembling this. I'll start from the bottom and go up. So the square plate goes on something like here. I will not forget to put my, and that's actually the advantage of having these two different screws, is that I can put one screw first, and let's put the right screw first. And I'll put this correctly, so then now I can tie the whole thing together to begin with, like so, and just order it like there will be more, we'll straighten up later. And now we can put the bottom bracket, like so. And the reason we have a washer here is just that the screw was not the correct length, so we needed to shorten the length of the screw a little bit to not take up too much of the thread from the others. We can put the servo and the, and actually it shouldn't matter which one of the two holes you put this in, the shaft. Then we put in the servo from anywhere, and we have already on this M3, I think it's 45 millimeter, we've already cut off so that we get sort of a flat head, like a screw bit, and we just plunge it into any one of those, and I'll just snap fit down there, and then this one sits. It won't kind of fall out in the long run. Doesn't really matter how you orientate things. We put the spacers on top, and on top of this we need to put the switching tooth, but the switching tooth needs spacers underneath and above and in between, so there is this middle spacer that actually goes into the hole and directs how much the tooth can turn, so it limits the turn, this small washer here, so that's very important. So what I do is I'll put all these three washers first, so I got it all, then I'll put the screw and the last washer, and then I'll put that on my assembly down from the top and screw it into the inserts. So, make sure it's loose, just tighten it a bit to get the washers in place. So it should have a tiny bit of friction, and I can sort of adjust. And here's a good idea to use treadlock on these screws. You can paste the, or put the treadlock beforehand, but that might be too much. You can experiment a bit with that. So I'll put on the shaft, I'll put my first M3 nut, then I'll put my switching tooth, And see, now I did it actually a bit wrong, but it's pretty quick to correct, because I want my arm, switching arm, to hang on to the switching tooth on this peg. I could just bend up the other peg as well and use that one, like so. But I think I'll just move over the shaft to the other hole. Just pull out my servo to the bottom. Use the other insertion hole. I'm turning the servo at the same time. See if we can get through. And this is a little bit of a question of tolerance. You might need to loosen the whole thing up a little so to get through. And here is also a good idea to just carefully turn it a bit to see that it actually the servo can turn. And then tighten the screws again a little. Put the top, the bottom nut. And then we're going to counter screw these two nuts so they tighten against each other. And this is the principle for adjusting where this is sitting. And then you can use the software to set it in the middle position when you initialize your servos. They should all sit in the middle position, and then you can counter tighten these using a key. But only don't do it before you have hooked up the servo, because the servo might turn up to 180 degrees when you turn it on, and then you'll just break the top arm here. But this top arm is designed to break before the servo overstrains itself. So that's it, assembly.